Okay guys, we are back again with the baby album. I'm gonna do a quick run through and show you what I've done. I've gone through and anything I had that I wanted to turn into a pocket, I stuck that down, okay? So I have a pocket there. Then I have this little card glued down. This little card, I stuck something on that pocket. And I just kind of went through and stuck cards where I could stick them. Okay, anywhere. Like this is one that people had written in so much that I didn't cut it apart. I went ahead and used it and just stuck it down like it was. So I've got all of that done with the cards. You see, I've made some pockets in different places to put stuff in. Now, I told you I wanted to do something with this binder that I left duct tape, silver duct tape. And here's what I'm going to do. First, and I'm going to turn this facing me so I can work on it and you see it. I have the binder facing me. It's going to be kind of hard for you guys to tell in this camera view, but I've tried figuring out a better way to do it, and I just don't have one. I don't have a better spot. But this is the edge that is duct tape facing me, and this is our front cover. Now, I'm going to open this up, and when I do, you can see that the duct tape stops on either side. What I'm going to do is take ribbon. That is, remember I did this about half an inch? This is about half an inch wide. And I'm going to adhere that down there in that closure. And then when it flips over, like I'll actually put glue along there so this ribbon will stay still. Then when I close it, I'm going to come out here and I'm going to tie a bow. Okay? And I'm going to do that in every single place that it binds. So that would be the first one. Then I'd open the next one. Same thing. With that same ribbon that fits in there just perfect, okay? On the outside, I'm going to end up tying bows in different locations, like here, 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 just kind of running down the side, there'll be bows. Then I'll have places I can put little charms and things if I want to. So I'm going to use this ribbon, and I'm going to alternate it with other ribbons because I want it to kind of complement the book. So I'm going to pick some other colors that will match. So I'm just going to do that real quick and show you what it looks like. I suggest you go ahead and tie your bow first before you adhere it down on the inside. The reason for that is you want to be sure you have enough ribbon because, you know, sometimes a bow can cause you heartache and you have to really struggle. And sometimes you need a little extra ribbon here and there. Plus, this way I can tie it and then roll it to where I want it to be on the book. Now, you will want to do something to keep that from opening because your recipient, you don't want them to have to tie them all the time. But there's different things you can do. You can run glue into the knot. You can run a stitch through the knot if you'd rather do that. I know a lot of people do that. Okay, so there's my first bow. And I'm going to get all the sticky off my hand first because it's stuck to me. Goodness. Okay, now I'm going to take it, and I'm just going to, this is what I was telling you, you can roll it where you want it as long as you don't adhere it down too soon. So see, I rolled it kind of to the top, so there's bow number one. Now I'm going to open it and adhere it. And I'm going to use some zip dry for that. You could use hot glue because this is ribbon. I'm just really into this zip dry lately. Okay, and then you just want to sit that down on there. So there's your first piece done. So now whenever the recipient opens it, all they'll see is a pretty piece of ribbon in the middle. And they won't see your workings. They'll just see your ribbon. That glue is wet, so you'll see that glue till it dries up. All right, and then you'll just go to the next one and do the same thing. Okay, I'm going to let you see all my mess because I want you to be able to see this. Here's what I did. Okay, so on the side, if I hold it at an angle, you see I have a bow here, okay? And then I have a little diaper pin tied into that ribbon. Then I have a little block, an ABC block tied here, a little buggy, like a little baby carriage, and then another bow tied at the end. So I just kind of made that kind of busy on the end. And when you hold it like this, it's just super cute, all the little ribbons and the bows on the side like that. So what I thought I would do is go in and work on my front cover and let you guys see what I'm going to do here. It's so funny how much junk I have in my craft room. This is actually from my baby niece, Lydia. This is from her invitations. So this one I've had a while. I think that's so sweet that I'll get to use this again on Piper's. Look how perfect that is. Ah, love it. And we're gonna do something fun. Recognize these little guys? These little clear elastics? We're gonna make bow tying super simple now. So these are clear, so they're not gonna show. And I'm gonna take this ribbon and just kind of make my bow as loopy as I want it. I think little girl things just need bows on them. I'm gonna send that underneath where my hand is. Flip this one over too. And all I'm doing is just really being messy. And then I'm going to take this little hair dually, these little clear thing, and wrap it around the center. Twist it just like if you were doing somebody's hair. These little guys are perfect because they get really tight. They'll cinch the center in. And now all we have to do is play with the ribbon and get it where we want it. And what I like about them is I want the center of this bow to be pretty flat. So that's what I like, is it's not going to take up a whole bunch of bulk. Here's another trick. Put your finger in both loops and pull, and they get even. Now they're perfectly even. And let's glue it down. This I am going to hot glue. Okay, so what I have done so far is I tied my bow and then I glued it down. And I want to show you something that you might want to try. If you'll take your ribbon and swirl it on the end like this, you can glue it down in little sections. Like I glued, look at the hot glue. Ugh. I glued this loop down and then I glued this loop down. So I know they stay in place, you know, but they look pretty. Then over here, I took some thickers, American Crafts thickers, which are called Boardwalk. And I put her name down the side. They're a little hard to see in the camera, but right here it says Piper. Her name is Piper. So that's going down the side. And then I found the cutest. I found this button. It was actually just a button. And then I found this other little pearly piece that I think just has to go right here. I just think it does. So I'm going to hot glue that in place. Oh, that looks so cute right there. So I have that glued there. And then I have all of these little guys that I've shown you, these little three-dimensional things I got from the Dollar Tree. And I want to put some of those on here too. So I'm just going to be hot gluing them. I like the hot glue to paper because, you know, it really sticks good, actually. You do have to clean the strings up a good bit, which can be a pain. But they stick good. This little pink baby bracelet would be cute, I think, hanging out of here like so. I'm going to stick that in there. So I'm just going to kind of push it up inside here like that, making sure it says baby the right way, and it does. If you remember this card that had the booties on it, I think I have to put these little white booties on here because they're so cute. I just don't know how I want to do them. I might want to do them with the little clothespins because they are so cute. See how that looks? Oh, that's cute. So put the little pins. I don't want to cover up her name. So, what if I do one there and one there? Just clip you on. Oh, I like that, yep. Okay, isn't it funny how sometimes you just let it drop and you're like, yep, that's where it goes. I'm just hot gluing off to the side, guys, to keep some of the strings off of here. I'm still gonna have to clean some of them up. But hopefully not as many by doing it off of my silicone mat. And this way, these will come off if she ever wants to play with them and put them back on. Oh, it's getting cute. Okay, what else can we bling it up with? I'm into blinging up right now. I thought these buttons were super cute. I may save them for inside, or they might be cute on these little buttons on the out, I mean, on these bows. I don't want to put too much where they might fall off, you know? Let's keep looking. These little pearls were on a card. They're not really pearls, they're just little beads. I don't know about those. Let's see what else I have in my box. That would be cute there for some color. Do I want green or do I want yellow? Oh, I think I like the, well, I got yellow there. Let's see about a blue one. Nope, I don't like the blue. I think I like the green. So I'm going to put that on right there. Cute. Then I have one of these little blocks. Is this how you guys do it? Like, oh, that's cute right there, huh? But it needs a little something on the top. How about a button? One of these little pink flower buttons. Yep. More hot glue. This little guy in the hot glue. That's cute. And then more hot glue on the back. I'm gonna put it right here. Now, my friend I'm giving this to is not a frilly thing. She's not into frills and blah, blah, blah. So this is really enough for her. It's probably more than her little mind will be able to comprehend anyway. Because she's like, it's so busy. But look how cute that is. Isn't that precious? And then we just go into all the pretties inside. So all you do at this point is decorate the inside like you would any mini album. You're going to put your tags in and you're going to embellish the pages how you want to. And you just have a good time. So that has been the greeting card album. Let me show you what we ended up with. We ended up with all of these tags to go inside. This is like a little tag. Here's a tag. I mean, I ended up with so many tags made from her greeting cards. And they'll just get stuck inside here in different ways. I've poked holes in them because I want to put a piece of ribbon in each one. Just something to kind of dress it up a little bit. But they'll just get stuck down in here. All over the place. And every single pocket there is, there will be tags. And I also have plenty of inserts. You know, we made all those inserts to go on the inside. And I want to show you one more thing I did on the insert real quick. And that is where people had done handwritten cards and I took it off. If you remember, I took it off the card itself so I could use the pieces. This is what I did. I stuck it down on my mat pieces that go inside. So for example, that's one. And then this one was a card where everybody had written all over it, including in the crease. And I couldn't really cut it. So I glued that on one of the mats that'll go inside the bag that'll slide in. So that gives you an idea. And what I'll do is once I get it all put together, I'll do a video showing you all of it and I'll do it in a better space so you can see every little bit and that way you'll get to enjoy all of it. But we are really close to being done. I'm just going to put all the tags inside, put some cute little things in there, and we are done. Thanks for coming along on this journey, guys. Any questions, just ask me. I'll try to answer them. I know it's hard to see this the way it's filmed, but I'll do my best. Thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.